shine bright like a diamond. Fine light in the beautiful sea, I chose to be happy. You and I, you and I, we're like diamonds in the sky. You're a shooting star I see, a vision of ecstasy. When you hold me, I'm alive, we're like diamonds in the sky.
Ladies and gentlemen, parents, guardians, I would now like to call upon our principal, Ms. White, for her address.
Thank you, Mr. Strauss. Good evening, everyone, and welcome to this very special ceremony, the formal induction of our grade eights into Greenside High School. This tradition dates back to 1984, and it remains one of our school's most meaningful ceremonies. The move from primary to high school is a potentially stressful and frightening one. Greenside's orientation program aims to reduce anxiety and make our children feel welcome and at home. I hope we have succeeded. I'd like to extend a special thank you to Ms. Gibbard, Mrs. Moyo, and Mr. Fesh, the grade team members taking ownership of this grade eight group. These passionate, efficient, and very hardworking professionals will play a pivotal role in your child's first year at Greenside, and hopefully the other four. I'd also like to thank the senior leaders who have worked with the grade eight team during orientation week and who will continue to be here for the grade eight learners. Most of you will have met Mr. Strauss at the welcome morning held in November last year. Mr. Strauss is the deputy in charge of Grade 8, and he plays a particularly important role in the well-being of our learners. Thank you to our Grade 8 form teachers who are here tonight. They also have an important role to play, both in administration and pastoral care. I'm going to introduce them. It always amazes me with teachers. They love teaching in front of a class, but ask them to stand up at a function like this, and it's sort of like the kiss of death. But if they could please just take their few minutes of fame so we can start putting names and faces together. Grade 8 blue is Mr. Farina. Thank you. Grade 8 green, Mr. Shezi. Grade 8 pink, Ms. Longwani. Grade 8 red, Ms. Groombridge. Grade 8 silver, Ms. Govender. And Ms. Govender, is she there? Okay, super. I didn't see you. She was here running around with chairs, so I thought maybe she got trapped upstairs or something. And grade 8 yellow, Mr. Gangot. Thank you. The Grade 8 Information Morning, which takes place on Saturday, the 26th of January, will afford you the opportunity to get acquainted with the school's management team, members of our governing body, and your child's educators. In everyone's life, at some time, our inner fire goes out. It is then burst into flame by an encounter with another human being. We should all be thankful for those people who rekindle the inner spirit. I hope that the symbolism of tonight's candle lighting ceremony will remain with you and your children in the time ahead. At the heart of this induction ceremony is the message that we want our children to be a happy and united group, looking out for one another and making the most of every opportunity to learn, achieve, and grow. Welcome.
Enthusiasm is the electricity of life. How do you get it? You act enthusiastic until it becomes a habit. Good evening to our principal, Ms. White, members of the governing body present tonight, grade heads, esteemed colleagues, parents, and last but certainly not least, our diamonds in the rough, the grade 8 learners, class of 2023. Ladies and gentlemen, parents, guardians, the words our diamonds recited as I was making my way to the podium were in fact four of the 10 pillars we strive to instill into our learners' lives at Greenside High School. These values should always guide every member of the Greenside High community. Our school's manifesto reads, individuality through community. Individuality, the first value as mentioned by the Diamonds. Individuality is the quality that makes you different from all other people. In other words, grade eights, as a school, we are encouraging you to be who you want to be, as long as it is within the parameters of the code of conduct. Dr. Seuss says, be who you are and say what you feel, because those who mind don't matter, and those that matter don't mind. The third value is respect. Respect is defined as the attitude of regarding someone as important so that you do not harm them or treat them rudely. Grade eights, before you can respect somebody else, you need to learn to respect yourself. You see, grade eights, respect is a two-way street. You need to give it to get it. My advice to you would be to respect yourself, respect adults, respect your peers, and also respect our school. Pillar number five is enthusiasm. This is a strong feeling of interest and enjoyment, an eagerness to be involved. Diamonds, as you stand at the threshold of a new chapter in your life, are you enthusiastic? Are you ready to grab all the opportunities the school has to offer with both hands? Are you going to get involved? Are you planning on making your mark? The difference between a successful individual and a non-successful individual is their attitude towards life. One's attitude towards life can either create dreams or destroy them. What is your dream, my children? What is it that your heart is yearning for? Come on, let's do some silent introspection. Where do you see yourself in the near future? Do you see yourself as a successful entrepreneur, a committed doctor saving other people's lives, a philanthropist? Could it perhaps be a teacher who cultivates the process of teaching others to find their true purpose in life? Come on, let's invigorate our thoughts. But then, let's get back to reality. In order to achieve those dreams and reach for the stars, you've got to put goals in place. Grade eights, let me tell you something about goals. Goals need to be SMART. Goals need to be specific. The M, it needs to be measurable and meaningful. Goals need to be attainable and achievable. Goals need to be relevant. Goals need to be time-based. You can achieve your goal. You just need to be smart about it. The road to success is never an easy one, but it is certainly worth it. The ninth value is honor. Grade eights, you have chosen to come to Greenside High School to complete your high school career. So it is in fact your responsibility to honor our school. Never bring the school's name into disrepute. I encourage you to be honest at all times and always to have integrity. Do the right thing, even when nobody is watching. Be accountable for your actions. As a child, I was absolutely fascinated by the Disney animated movie, The Lion King. But more specifically, one of the songs sung in this movie, The Circle of Life. As I was preparing for this evening's proceedings, I couldn't help but to think how befitting and relevant this song is for you, Diamonds, sitting in this auditorium this evening. There is one particular stanza or paragraph that fills my soul with an immense amount of joy every time I listen to the song. It says, "There's far too much to take in here, more to find than can ever be found. But the sun rolling high through the sapphire sky keeps great and small on the endless round." Diamonds, there is so much for you to take in here at Greenside High School. And as a school, we will always strive to cater for your needs, to develop the uniqueness of each and every single one of you. Diamonds, I implore you to strive for excellence as you reach for your dreams. Remember, dreams don't become a reality through magic. It takes sweat, determination, and hard work. If you don't believe this, then take note of this. Diamonds are beautiful and shine bright, but without pressure, there would be no diamonds.
After this speech, I don't know what to say. I'm really challenged, but good evening, Miss White, educators, parents, and our beautiful diamonds in the rough, as well as senior leaders. To the parents, I was not here on the first day. I am Mrs. Moyo, and I hope you are going to work with me with our diamonds in the rough. Today we are inducting you and welcoming you in the Greenside family. Our goal is your education. So what makes a great learner? A learner is one who understands their types of unique intelligence and their strengths and weaknesses and takes advantage of the strengths and works to improve on the weaknesses. One who sets goals that guide how to guide time and energy. You heard about SMART. I'm not going to talk about SMART. So what is your obligation? Our former president, I'm a historian and I'm a history teacher. I like history. Our former president, Barack Obama, the president of the United States of America, once said to the students, "At the end of the day, we can have the most dedicated teachers, the most supportive parents, and the best schools in the world, yet none of it will matter unless all of you fulfill your responsibilities. Unless you show up to those schools, pay attention to those teachers, listen to your parents, grandparents, and elders, and put in the hard work it takes to succeed, that is your obligation." And that's what I want you to focus on today, the responsibility each one of you has for your education. I want you to start with the responsibility you have to yourself. That's the opportunity an education can provide. Education starts by challenging one's personal life and ends up changing the world. The only real failure in life is the failure to try. Never give up to trying to fulfill your dreams and ideas. In the end, everyone who tries will succeed. And if you haven't succeeded, then you have not reached the end. Remember, be proud of who you are, what you have already achieved so far. I think you have achieved until now because you are coming to us as a result of your achievements. Keep moving ahead and set your goals high. Believe in yourself. Throughout the orientation week, we have been giving you information that will help you kickstart the life at Greenside High School. What we are expecting from you now is that you reciprocate by putting everything we taught you in practice. At Greenside, we focus in your education. You will soar to greater heights, But as diamonds in the rough is our theme for you, we are reminding you of the value of a diamond. One, that is its weight, its color, its clarity, its cut, and its cost. We believe that you'll emerge to be pure diamonds, which will have the most value in our country. I would like to introduce one of our learners who was here at Greenside High School and happened to be the graduate from grade 8 to grade 12, who is Tinotenda Mdzingwa, who has proved to be valuable to the country and the world at large. I'll ask Tinotenda to come forward.
Good evening, Ms. White, parents, teachers, learners, and educators. And good evening to our senior leaders as well. Class of 2023, 5 years ago, I was where you are today, and I was scared. I was scared of the big unknown that is high school. I was worried about adapting to a place so entirely new and so big. But looking back, all of that fear was accompanied by a strange kind of excitement. The thing about a new and strange place is that it's filled with new opportunities and experiences that are waiting to be unwrapped by you. Not all of these experiences will be fun, but each of them will have a unique lesson to teach. I urge you to take advantage of every opportunity. Try new sports, try new extracurricular activities, learn more about the people around you and about yourselves, but don't neglect your academics. Take advantage of the teachers you have who are ready and willing to help you every step of the way. Class of 2023, diamonds in the rough. Matric is not as far away as it may seem, but it is also still a ways away. Enjoy your high school career, and I hope that at the end of it all, you will be able to proudly say that you did your best and did so consistently. I hope that you are able to then think of your future with joy and the strange kind of excitement that whispers to you that even greater things are on their way.
Okay, as you can see from the slides, for those who are looking, I think you saw the marks which Tinotenda got. She was the top learner in Gauteng. Thank you, Tinotenda. So grade 8 is possible. There's no impossibilities as long as you work very hard. And I challenge you today, just like Tinotenda, we challenged Tinotenda in 2014, we are also challenging you in 2019. So that when you come to 2023, we are going to have the same marks as we see here as displayed on the board. Now, the grade 8s will sing their jingle. Before they could do that, I would like to take this opportunity to thank Leila Mayet, our deputy head girl, for taking a precious time to make the diamond for our grade 8s. She handmade this diamond as a gift to the diamonds in the rough. It is held together by the strongest forces in the universe: hot glue, duct tape, determination, and love. Contained within it, like a time capsule, are the dreams, goals, and aspirations of the grade 8s, kept open for the diamonds yet to come. Each promise was individually read and placed in the diamond by the senior leaders to value each child as they began the journey into Greenside. On the back, the senior leaders have marked out space for us to cut open the diamond at our matric valedictory ceremony in 2023. Leila describes the diamond as a labor of love for the grade 8s, and used it as a metaphor for high school that she has asked us to share. Anxiety kept her restless, and sped her into action, producing something she excelled at it, an artistic and practical way, in an act of passion for the school. Naturally, such tasks do not come together without some battle scars. As it turns out, hot glue and hands do not react well. She related every experience to closing the circle of her school career with lessons to pass to the next generation. The anxiety, the two all-nighters, the pain and injury, the healing and patience are with herself and with the project. The gathering independence and the deep passion and sincere love that drove her to produce the best she could. This diamond is the gift that the class of 29 hereby hands to the diamonds in the rough. On the back, we can find the names of every single senior leader that sits on the body, which held the hands of the grade 8s as they took their first vital step onto the next stage of their lives. And you have all grown to love and cherish each and every diamond seated here tonight. We really appreciate your effort, Leila Mayed. The grade 8s will sing the jingle. They took time to learn it, and I hope you'll enjoy it. I thank you.
Parents, as you may know, the grade 8 learners attended school in civilian clothes for the duration of the orientation program, which was completed on Friday last week. The reason for this was because we wanted our diamonds to be most comfortable as we began the shaping and molding process. The second reason for this was because we wanted to formally introduce our diamonds to our school at a special ceremony like this. Grade 8s, after going through the jam-packed, perhaps tiring orientation program, I think it is safe to say that you are now Greenside ready. And without any further ado, I would now like to invite you to put on your blazer as you now belong to the Greenside family. You are now a young Greensider. Welcome to our school, Grade 8s, where your future is our priority.
Evening, ladies and gentlemen, and most importantly, to our diamonds. Can I please ask that you guys sit down? Whew, what a workout. Okay. Mind over matter. Your mind can be a very powerful healing tool when given the chance. Who here has heard of the placebo effect? The placebo effect, besides the parents, any grade 8s? No one. Okay. For those of you who haven't, a placebo is used in clinical trials to test the effectiveness of certain medication. For instance, people in one group will consume the drug that is being tested, whilst the other group will consume a fake drug, known as the placebo, that they think is real. The idea that your mind can convince your body that a fake treatment is a real thing is just absolutely remarkable. I'd like to relate this back to one of my personal experiences. Paging back to my high school introduction, I had done really well for myself. Grade 8, I received the Pro Merito Award, excelling in sport, culture, and academics. Grade 9, I began playing provincial rugby and touch rugby, still maintaining my academic record. Grade 10, however, I got badly injured just before the June exams, sustaining severe fractures to my back. I didn't write my exams, and I was physically unfit to do anything but lie on my bed. With that said, I couldn't do anything or go anywhere without a back brace. Now, you can imagine. I nearly missed 2 whole months of school. Going from straight A's to barely passing, going from loving physics to hating every moment spent in class, going from playing sports every single afternoon to absolutely fearing the field, going from being such a busybody to having so many limitations came as such a hard blow to me emotionally, physically, and mentally. But I was determined to heal. I was determined to get back on track. I worked to walk on my own again. I worked to get back on that sports field. I worked to pass grade 10. Mind over matter, grade 8s. Mind over matter. Can you say it for me? Everyone experiences high school differently, but I can vouch that as challenging as it can be, it always gives way for personal growth. To the culture vultures like Asante over here, do drama, do dance, do sing, make the stage your home. To the sports people like me over here, run those fields and courts, swim till your fingers begin to curl. Like Ethan over there, can you stand up and just show them the swimmer that you are? To the creative minds, paint your hearts away. Draw out your poetic essence. To the academic, which should be all of you, study hard for that A. To the all-rounders, to you grade 8s, enjoy every single high school moment. Indulge in every experience. Try till it becomes achievable. And do till it's achieved. Thank you. I'd now like to welcome my better half, or so they say, the head boy of Greenside High School, Asante Amin.
Thank you, Leke. Welcome to Greenside. You are the diamonds in the rough. To achieve success, you've got to rise above. And don't forget to dream, the sky's the only limit. Good thing about a dream is that it has no limit. Grade 8, through the next 5 years of your lives, I hope you live by the lyrics of your jingle. Not because it's fun to dance to, but because it's phenomenal to live by. You are the diamond in the rough. What does that mean? For me, it means you are valuable, precious, and beautiful. Not as individuals, but as a community. Before welcoming and orientating you into the school, I said that my goal for you was not to inspire, because that would come naturally, but to change each and every single one of your lives. The reason for this is because I know each and every single one of you can achieve greatness and success. We all have dreams and goals, but the difference lies in when you actually achieve them. When you feel the satisfaction of working hard, to wake up in the morning knowing that you have determination to be down. It's waking up in the morning to be enthusiastic through the low, positive through the negatives, loyal through the distrust, but most importantly, phenomenal through the rough. I can attest to you that the next 5 years are not going to be easy, but they definitely will build, shape, and mold you into the shining diamonds that you all desperately seek to be. Yes, you can all achieve it, but it's not easy. Let me not sugarcoat and say that it's one fairy tale, because you will go through terrors. But all those terrors will make you stronger. A quote I think you should always remember and live by is, diamonds are formed under pressure. Diamonds are formed under pressure. If there is no pressure, then there is no value. If there is no hard work, then there is no outcomes. If there is no determination, then there is no endurance. And if there is no zest, then there is no individuality. Be the individual that you are meant to be. Be the community that will play a large role in our society. But be the diamond Greenside will shape into your own realities. In such a short space of time, I really love each and every single one of you. And I wish you nothing but the best. Your smiles and laughter is what will definitely keep me going. Myself, Laken, and the senior leaders are here to motivate you, stand by you, but most importantly, lead you. For the next upcoming year and preceding years to follow, let all of us go out there and make magic. Remember that we are here and we won't go astray. You are our diamonds that we have to get through the rough. Thank you.
Thank you, Laken and Asante. We would now like to call upon the senior leaders to lead the grade eights in singing the school war cries. Well done, grade eights. You can remain standing. Ladies and gentlemen, parents and guardians, as we continue with our program this evening, it now gives me great pleasure to allow you to witness a long-standing tradition at our school. The flame represents enlightenment, growth, and truth that the senior leaders, as representatives of the learners at our school, has come to recognize throughout their high school journey. The senior leaders will now pass on the qualities or symbolism of the flame to the diamonds in the rough through a candle lighting ceremony. Parents, this process may be slightly prolonged, and I'm asking if you could please bear with me, as it is absolutely pivotal for us as a school to welcome each individual through this process. May I please ask you to cue the music? Like a diamond. Shine bright like a diamond. Fine light in the beautiful sea. I chose to be happy. You and I, we're like diamonds in the sky. You're a shooting star I see, a vision of. Allow me to lead you as you say the school pledge. Grade 8s, you can repeat after me. I do solemnly swear,
I do solemnly swear
that I will uphold,
that
The honor of Greenside High School.
The honor of Greenside High School.
I vow to cherish the 10 pillars.
I vow to cherish the 10 pillars.
Which are the foundation of my education.
Which are the foundation of my education.
I vow to exercise.
I vow to exercise.
All the skills, knowledge, and abilities.
Which I will acquire.
For the betterment of myself.
For the welfare of my family.
And for the service of my country. Thank you.
Wow. Grade 8 learners, very well done. I think after tonight, I actually forget all the stress that we went through last week. Okay, good evening. So as you can see, our learners did extremely well during the orientation program last week. Even though their days were long, learners displayed a positive attitude the entire week. The effort they put into learning the war cry was amazing. They showed so much enthusiasm and were so eager to perfect it, as we've seen tonight. What touched my heart was the manner in which they performed the jingle. The jingle was created from the speech I used at the welcome morning, and it included the vision we had for the learners. The first time I heard it, I was amazed at how well they performed. And tonight, it was absolutely perfect. Very well done. Learners, thank you for being so well behaved last week. It made the orientation program fun and successful. Parents, please remember to contact us if you have any concerns and queries. You are welcome to email us or call the front office and leave a message for us to get back to you. Thank you for attending the induction ceremony this evening. Refreshments will be served outside in the Rose Garden. And we are also available if there are any issues you would like to discuss. Remember, communication is the key to building relationships. I can't end the function tonight without saying thank you to Mr. Strauss for everything that he's assisted with. And as you saw earlier, the enthusiasm and eagerness also rubbed off onto the senior leaders. Senior leaders, thank you. We definitely would not have been able to do it without you. Thank you so much. Can we please stand for the procession to leave the hall?